We are going to win.
Quit making national heroes out of those who steal secrets and publish them in the newspaper.
The hundreds of thousands we were killing was unjustified homicide, and I couldn't see the difference between that and murder. Murder had to be stopped.
This weekend, portions of a highly classified Pentagon document came to light for all the world to see, and brought cries of outrage from Washington.
We gotta get this son of a bitch.
Yes, Kennedy did send in troops in violation of the Geneva Accord. Johnson did start the buildup before he said he was going to. These guys were lying through their teeth when they were talking to us. And here it is in black and white. There's no way of denying it.
The Times building is encircled by armed guards. We are printing tomorrow a top-secret government document.
A name has now come out as the possible source of the Times Pentagon documents. It is that of Daniel Ellsberg, the top policy analyst for the Defense and State Department.
I am prepared to answer to all the consequences of these decisions.
Henry Kissinger said that Daniel Ellsberg was the most dangerous man in America, and he had to be stopped.
The study was 47 volumes, 7,000 pages. It would take me months of Xeroxing.
We've dropped another 200,000 tons of bombs on Indochina. That's 10 Hiroshimas, one Hiroshima a week.
What has remained significant about the release of the Pentagon Papers is the decision by a public official to give priority to conscience as compared to career.
Daniel Ellsberg, whatever his intentions, gave aid and comfort to the enemy.
It was a crime from the start, carried out by four presidents, and now a fifth president was doing the same.
I'm not going to be part of this system of lying anymore.
It wasn't that we were on the wrong side. We were the wrong side.